alumni. Yo, what is up, guys? It's your boy Siswitch here, bringing you guys a tour on how to make your sexy ass inside modeling-ness in a logo or a text. So, yeah, I asked you guys on my recent speed art if you guys wanted a tutorial, and I said if you get 20 likes, and you guys smashed it. So, thanks so much for those 20 likes, and now I expect you guys to like the crap out of every single one of my videos and not have me ask. Just saying. Anyways, I'm going to use the Era logo for this, and there's going to be a slight difference between doing what I'm going to show you in like the next 2 minutes between logos and using a text or whatever. So let's get going. Let's get started. So basically what I said, I told you I'm going to be using the Era logo. So I'm going to have my extrude nerves here, and I'm just going to shift click on all of them, and change the caps to fillet cap on both of them, and put my steps to 1 and radius to 2. You can copy that on whatever logo you're using and fix your extrude nerves. And basically want to make sure they're all selected by shift clicking. Right-click, make editable, or press C on your keyboard, which will start off the boom. So, yeah, you want to make sure it has these little blue triangles on the left side of it, so that's, you know, you're in the same place as I am. And you want to go to the left side of your selection stuff, and you want to click on the 1/4 box with a little orange cut, orange little space right there. You want to click on the second to last one right here. That's how you are able to click on, you know, stuff inside the logo or whatever. So now we're going to start with the E first, which is going to be the last one right here. And you want to go ahead and click the plus button so you can't click it no more on the round ending 1, or rounding 1. So you want to go ahead and click on your extrude nerves. And for sure, this is definite. This is why I said a little bit of difference between the Motex and then a logo. If you're using, if you're making the inside modeling on a logo, you're definitely going to have extrude nerves rounding 1 and rounding 2. You want to click on rounding 1, and this will bring you to cap 1. This will allow you to click on the front of the logo, which is what you're going to need. But the little difference between the, you know, text, I'm going to show you a little bit. Right, show you real quick. So if I press C on the keyboard, it's going to, you know, group all this crap. If it doesn't do that for you, I don't know why it does it for me. But let's say if you're going to, you know, have your text or whatever, you're going to, you know, press C on your keyboard, and it pops up. The only difference is going to be there's no rounding 1, there's just cap 1. So that's what you're going to be using. So, not a big difference, but just a slight difference, so just so I don't lose anybody. Like, I don't say rounding 1. It's basically your cap 1. Whichever's your cap 1 is what you're going to be selecting. That's going to be to allow you to select the front. So, yeah. Let's get going. Doing good right now. So, right now, as you can see, you have these little green lines, and you're able to select the front of it or whatever, and you're able to play with it. To make the little cuts inside, that's what we're going to show you how to do. Basically what, you know, happens, you see these little, like, indents in, like, the letter or whatever, and you see these little, like, you know, cogwheels or, gears inside of it, and it makes it look all cool. So I'm gonna show you guys how to do that. Show you guys how to make a little cut inside the, logo. You're gonna have to right-click and go to your knife. Oops, that's a mirror, bro. Your knife. And, you can need to go to structure. Nice, knife also. So, basically what your knife does, if you click outside or, like, you know, around your place, so if you were to, like, click around it, like outside, and then drag it, and you just mix a little slice right here. You see what I'm doing? Basically what I'm going to do is like make two parallel lines right now, for now. See how like I make two parallel lines? I'm going to do a little bit farther apart. No, that's too far apart. Two parallel lines, see that? And I have this like place that I have selected where I like cut off the whole entire thing, but made this little piece so I can only edit this part. I'm also going to like cut it off a little bit, make a little like trapezoid shape. Cause that's how I like it right there. See, I just did two other cuts, just like so, and I made a little trapezoid-looking like shape. And now this is where the part where to make the indention, you want to right-click, or go to extrude. You want to click on your selected part that you just created, and you want to go to your offset. It's gonna be at 5. You want to change it to about -10 or 15. I'm gonna change it about -10. And You want to like, if you turn my camera, you can see that it's indented a little bit. So, there you go. That's how you indent stuff. And you can do it, you know, for the rest, and then you can just place your cogwheels or your gears or whatever inside. Right here, this is basically the main thing you need to learn how to do, is make cuts inside the thing. Inside the logo or the text or whatever. That's the main thing. If you guys already know how to model, from now on, you can stop watching. But if you guys don't know how to make a cogwheel or slash gear, I can show you guys how to do that right now. So, for the people who know how to model, thanks for watching. See you later. So, peace. Otherwise, keep on watching, because I'm going to show you a little more stuff. Anyways, to make a cogwheel slash gear, you want to go ahead and go to your spine, and then go to cogwheel. Whoa, bro, it says cogwheel. Yeah. Yeah, don't move it. Keep it where it places inside your Lightroom or your Cinema 4D, because if you move it, it's just going to make a little bit, you know, pain in the ass. So don't move it yet, and you want to click on your cogwheel and go to your teeth. It's going to have 20 teeth in the start. You can change it to about 6 or 8. I'm going to change it to about 6, and you want to just go to your extrude nerves now, and place your cogwheel inside your extrude nerves, and if you guys like, you know, the non-circle inside your gear or whatever, if you like, you know, if you like this part, or if you like it solid and that little circle inside, you can leave it here. But to make a circle inside your gear, all you gotta do is go to capsule, spot your solid shapes, and go to capsule, and then you want to rotate it so it's facing towards us, like so the point towards us, or the top part towards us, and you want to take your scale tool and just make it a little bit bigger. And this is why I told you not to move it, so it's simpler to do this. And you want to go to your Array tab and go to Boil. I hope I'm saying that word right. And you want to put your capsule below your extrude nerves, that's the cogwheel that's inside. And then you want to click on both of them, Control-click or Shift-click, and drag it inside the Boil. And as you can see, it made the capsule, like basically, you know, the circle. I don't know how to say it. It just gave it what it gave it. I don't know how to explain it. But it substituted the capsule as like the circle, so that's pretty cool, pretty sweet to make your just show you how to make a little circle inside your gear if you guys didn't want to keep it all plain or whatever. So now all we gotta do, if you want to shrink it, make sure you just click on the main part, which is, or the main group, which is the boil or whatever. Make sure you don't click on the capsule and try and move it or shrink it, because it's gonna mess everything up. It's not gonna have a circle in the middle or whatever. Or try and move the capsule, because that won't work either. Make sure you click on the top layer or the top group, and then you can move it. And then you can also shrink it to make it fit inside your little hole that you made, or little indention that you made in your text or whatever. So that's basically what I did when I did it for mine. If I can just pull it out, jeez. All right, there we go. So like I said, you can just shrink it to make it fit inside, and you want to rotate it in different spaces or places basically, and then just Control C V to make copies, and just keep on doing that. And rotate them in different ways so they just look, you know, unique, I guess. I don't know how to explain it, but that's how I would do it, just like so. And one other thing that you see a lot is the capsules looking like probes or whatever. So I'm going to show you guys how to do that real quick. Just a quick example, you need to copy me exactly. You can just make your own little thing, but the only tools you're going to be using when you try and model it is the... hold on, let me get on this. Is the... okay, we got to make the capsule editable. As soon as we fix the height. So I'm going to fix the height a little bit. And the radius, shrink it to about like 25. So it makes it a little bit skinny. And the height is just basically the height of your indention of your hole or whatever inside your text. But you don't need to actually put a hole when you're trying to put a capsule in, because it just wouldn't really make sense. So yeah, I now have my radius and height fixed for my capsule. I can make it editable by pressing C on my keyboard or right-click and make it editable. And the only thing you're going to be using when you try and model your capsule into like a probe-looking thing is bevel, extrude inner, and smooth shift. And a little quick tip, if you guys, you know, you can see like these cutoffs or whatever, you can click, and they can hold shift to click on more than one place. But as you can see, if, like I say, if you want to like, you know,